years ago when Dinnie Pales, the number one seed, decided to come in by train and lost his way and very nearly got scratched after being absent for 15 minutes. And here come the officials. And the usual procedure, the senior man on the court, the umpire, measuring the net, and here they come. They turn opposite the service line, out of the royal box, go forward to the chair to be greeted by the umpire, Martin Huntington. And we'll know who will have the choice or the privilege. And he has four choices. The man who wins the toss. One that's often forgotten is that he can ask his opponent to serve or to receive. He can ask him, the other man, to make the decision.
The toss?
No, I wonder if we can hear what he says, what happens here. Yes, no longer do we spin the racket for rough and smooth. Well, no doubt it will be announced when Martin Huntington gets into the chair, the result of the toss. But he's a Yorkshireman, very well-known sports journalist, and his wife used to be the professional lady champion of the Teachers Association.
And interestingly, he has been selected to be the chief umpire for the exhibition tennis that will take place for the first time at the Olympic Games in Los Angeles this year, and it becomes a full Olympic sport in Seoul in 4 years' time.
Well, now, Jimmy Connors hits his first ball on the centre court for this Wimbledon. 31 years of age, he's seeded number three, and he's three on the world computer. Born in Illinois, now lives in Florida. Wimbledon champion in 74 and 82, three times the runner-up, and he's playing his 13th championship meeting. The interesting thing, I think, is that he failed in his defense of the title last year, losing to Kevin Cullen of South Africa in the fourth round, and it was his earliest defeat at Wimbledon, never having failed to reach the quarterfinal in 12 years. Just over to his younger opponent, 24-year-old Stefan Simonsen, ranked number four in his own country, and he's 113 on the computer. And the reason for that is that there are so many players these days are so good, but he is in fact the lowest ranked, world ranked player amongst the Swedes, behind people like Gulander, Ekberg and Jared. He's playing his fourth Wimbledon since 1980. He had a hard but very fine win on Monday, beating Shlomo Glickstein of Israel. A very, very much better player, Glickstein, than many people think. And the Swede won 6-4 in the final set after being behind 1-2. And John Barrett knows this young man rather better than I do.
Well, he's one of a group of young Swedish players who have come to the fore of late, and his younger brother Hans overtook him a couple of years ago in the ATP computer rankings, but since then this man has gone back ahead of Hans. Hans better known for his doubles play. He and Anders Järryd have won the French doubles together. But this man is a forthright player who can play from the back of the court. He can also volley well. But I think today he's up against a man who is probably going to be just simply too good for him. They've only met once before, and that was on clay in 1980 at North Conway in the United States, part of their summer circuit. On that occasion, in the third round, Jimmy Connors won 6-3, 6-love. And I suppose the courts today here, the faster grass, is going to favour Jimmy even more. But Simonsen has been a good junior in Sweden. He was the 1976 Swedish junior champion. And in the following 2 years, he won their national outdoor championships and is now ranked at number 4 in his country, though, as you've heard, he has slipped down the ATP rankings down to about 113 at the moment.
Well, quite a lot of results coming in from the ladies' singles, and the number 7 seed in the ladies is through. The Bulgarian girl Manuela Malieva has beaten Natalia Rova of the Soviet Union 6-2, 6-2, and goes through to the third round to face Yvonne Vermaak of South Africa, who's put out Jenny Klitsch of the United States 6-3, 6-2. Ida Budarova of Czechoslovakia has beaten Alicia Moulton of the States 6-4, 6-4, and she will meet the winner of the Navratilova match next. And then Camille Benjamin of the United States has beaten her fellow American Wendy White 7-5, 6-3. And finally, the Russian girl Svetlana Chernyeva has beaten Felicia Rashiatori of the United States 6-3, 6-4.
Well, now, we've told you that the Swede won his first round match, but we didn't tell you or remind you that Mr. Connors won his 7-5, 7-5, 6-4 on court one on Monday. And he was playing against Lloyd Bourne of the from California. He was playing his third Wimbledon. A good win in straight set, 7-5, 7-5, 6-4. I don't think Connors, perhaps quite honestly, would be too pleased with his opening form at Wimbledon. Good enough to win in straight sets, but like his fellow countryman McEnroe, something of an idealist, never really satisfied with his game. Perhaps that's what's made, what has made him such a great player through the years. A marvellous record, Wimbledon winner twice and 5 times the US Open, and a man who every time he goes onto a competition court gives his all.
And of course once won in Australia back in 1974. So the only Grand Slam title he hasn't won is in France, and one thinks, Dan, that that chance now must almost have gone. He's 31 years old, and it takes a great deal of physical effort as well as anything else to win in Paris.
Simonsen to serve, first set.
So it'll be Stefan Simonsen, the young Swede, to open the match.
Love. 30 love.
A very lovely early ball under pressure there. And Simonsen.
'30-15.
This could well develop into a battle between the two-handers.
All right. 40-30.
And I'm quite sure by design that was a heavily sliced backhand, the ball kept low, and Connors not too happy on grass on the lowest ball on his forehand.
Advantage Simonsen.
I wonder if he'll go in behind his service this time. He's playing against the perhaps one of the finest returners of the service in the modern game.
Simonsen, first game.
He'll be pretty pleased, young Simonsen, about winning that serve, and particularly after a deuce, he had to work for it, and it's always an exciting thing to get into the swim of things, as it were, with some rallies and the chance to have exchanges like this last point of the game, where Jimmy Connors is probing with those raking ground strokes for depth, and he has a chance here either to come in or do what he did. The drop shot, but he's so quick off the mark, Simonsen, that he has time to find the angle that defeats Connors. And it was a well-contrived shot. I think Connors was waiting for the one just to be popped down the line. He would have leapt across with his forehand, with his backhand volley on that. So a good start. Connors, the serve, which has improved so much over the last 2 years, needs to be going well if he's going to challenge seriously at this championship. Love one.
Love 15.
Sort of backhand pass that he should have made. The Connors volley was rather short. This volley may have been short, but the approach shot from the Connors forehand was very, very deep then, and made the volley comparatively easy. Really, the first ball return of service at the feet of Connors made the resulting forehand pass an easy task.
A
really beautiful low volley, two-handed low volley below the height of the net of a very heavily topspun ball. He'll be pleased with that volley, I think, Connors.
Again, Connors. One game all.
One game all in this second round match, being played in the most lovely conditions. Very bright sun, hardly any wind.
Love 15. Fifteen all.
Nice play, but this man has a very high throw up. For men players these days don't usually throw the ball as high as that. On a windy day, he might have to suffer a little bit. Good service.
Gary Stevenson. Simonson leads by 2-1, first set.
We can check now on the progress of Stuart Bale, the young Briton out on number 14 court against Tom Gullickson of the Gullickson twins. Gullickson is two sets of love up, leading 5-4, and the score is 30 all. So 40-30.
40-30.
And Gullickson is at match point at the far end. And so young Bale, having heroically beaten John Alexander on Monday, now goes out to Tom Gullickson of the United States. Gullickson is through to the third round, 7-5, 6-3, 6-4. Now back to the centre court.
And Jimmy Connors it is now. At 1-2, there have been no breaks of serve.
Love.
Who thought Connors was going to knock a winner off with that deep ball?
Ah. 30 love.
Very close. Forty fifteen. Again, Connors. Two games all.
It's an interesting stroke that Connors played in the middle of that game, where he hit a heavily sliced ball to his forehand, the sort of ball that he worries about a little sometimes these days, but he played it really very well. Two all, first set.
Fifteen, love.
The fourth called. Lovely rally.
30, love.
Oh, the volley went into the net, but I think we have to give the credit for the point to the man who struck that very fine passing shot, or very nearly a passing shot.
Forty, love. 40, 15.
Well, I think it's in the mind of the server that one of the tactical ploys he must use is the backhand slice to the Connors forehand, particularly the half-court low ball. Yes, we're trying it again then, you see.
Yes. Advantage Connors.
So from 40 love to break point.
Game Connors. Connors leads 3-2, first set.
Now then, something a little unfortunate for somebody's car is happening out in Marriott Road, just alongside Wimbledon here, and it's a Daimler Princess, I'm told, that is on fire. And police and firemen in attendance, trying to put it out. Can't ever remember seeing that around the suburban roads of Wimbledon before. Now then, if we just move from that to number 3 court, we can investigate the fortunes of John Lloyd of Great Britain, who's out there playing against Greg Holmes. There's Lloyd, having a much more successful season. And it's gone with service. He's trailing 2-3. So we'll keep you up to date with the progress of that match between Lloyd and Greg Holmes of the United States. Now back to the centre court.
So the first break of serve to Connors. 3-2, first set.
Love.
Quite extraordinary how Connors seems to take an animal pleasure and delight in really giving an easy ball a terrific sort of wallop.
Pretty love.
Just a fort, but I think you noticed the improvement that was mentioned earlier about how Connors has improved his serve. Really terrific speed through there and penetration. The Connors ground strokes are carrying a lot of depth now.
Connors leads 4-2, first set.
Nice run of 3 to come from 1-2. This, of course, is his problem, how to serve and come in well enough to circumvent the great return of service.
Love, 30. club 40. Game Connors. Ball change. Connors leads 5-2, first set.
So Connors will be serving for that first set. Let's briefly have a look at the number one court scoreboard, the adjoining show court, where Martina Navratilova is playing Amy Holton of the United States. And just a few seconds ago, Martina won the first set. 6-2. Now we have a couple of singles results for you. In the men's, Steve Meister of the United States has put out Hans-Jörg Schweier of West Germany, 6-1, 6-3, 7-5. And in the ladies, Elizabeth Sayers of Australia has beaten Gretchen Rush of the United States, 6-4, 3-6, 6-2.
And the applause for Jimmy Connors, who's first away from the chair. And how well he's playing today. He's timing the ball so beautifully and generating this tremendous pace. And it's a pace that's going to get even greater as he now serves with the new balls. 5-2.
And that first double forward of the match stops the run. Connors has won until then 13 consecutive points.
There's a part of the Swedish cheering squad. Jan Anders Sjögren, who's the captain of the touring team, or was last year, of young Swedish players. And with him in the middle was Mats Wilander, the number four seed, and Jan Gunnarsson.
So two set points for Connors.
Game and first set, Connie. First set to Connors. 6-2.
6-2 in 27 minutes. And a lovely run of 5 games from 1-2.
Love 15. Dean all.
out. Yes, Connor,
30-15.
Connor's there indicating to himself as he put his arm out there. He hit the ball a little bit late and unintentional slice developed, and of course it floated away. Only a fraction late, of course, but by the time it gets to this end of the court, it's something like a foot out of its original direction. Problem is a difficult one here, the server. Beautiful half volley by Connors.
Deuce. Connors.
And really magnificent groundstroke play by Connors.
Advantage Connors.
Second break point for Connors.
Deuce. A advantage Simonsen.
Well, they hadn't played for 4 years when Connors won very easily, but I mention that because so many people who haven't played Connors forget that under pressure he plays some of his very finest shots on the run. But the young Swede was very, very aware of it then. Oh no.
Deuce. Connors.
Not really, of course, an instinctive volleyer, something of a made volleyer, and at this class of tennis, made volleyers have great trouble against really great groundstroke players. Got to be on the instinct level for really world-class volleying.
Longest, first set, Connors.
Longest game of the match, 4 deuces.
And one has a certain sympathy for Stefan Simonsen today because he's trying all he knows to hold his own from the back of the court. He's tried to go in occasionally as well. And the sort of problems he faces, as Dan Maskell said, it's a difficult problem for him because really his service isn't big enough for him to go in all the time. And he's Connors could easily have come in on that shot, which was really rather a short reply, but he's quite happy to slug it out from the back of the court where he knows he's going to win most of the rallies. And they're both just fencing for the opportunity either to make a telling ground shot that itself will be a winner or near winner, or the opportunity to come to the net on the right shot. And it's that very depth on the shot from Connors which allows him to come into the net and wrong foot his opponent totally. He could have gone either way there. And really, Simonsen knows that he can't really expect to follow his serves in too often because it's not a big enough serve and it's going to be rammed down his throat. And he's had 2 or 3 difficult first volleys to play and made a couple of errors on them.
Quiet, please.
Incidentally, John, that was a long game, 8 minutes that game took. Connors serving, one love, second set.
Dean Love.
These days they call that doing a Nastase. Years ago Nastase rolled off a brilliant shot like that, but rather nice to look at again.
First service.
Showing the enthusiasm of a youngster there, a little too impetuous.
Deuce. 30-all.
Bradley needs a break of service to lift his confidence, Simonson.
Two love to Connors, and what a beautiful point in the middle of that last game. Everything that Connors did here was right. He had a difficult shot to play there, the half volley, and the important thing there was to keep it deep. But the lob was a superb reply, and all he has time to do is to improvise over his shoulder. Now Simonson is dead because he's moving forward, and the lob absolutely strands him.
First service.
Love to.
Love 15. Love 30.
And a fine piece of improvisation by Connors there. Not the normal smash, throwing the racket head at the ball, but a round arm smash, rather like a bowler at cricket.
Love 40. Game Connors. Connors leads 3-0. Second set, first set Connors.
The match on number one court has taken a very interesting turn. Remember I told you that Sandra Ratilova had beaten Amy Holton in the first set 6-2. Well, suddenly Amy Holton has taken 3 games in a row off Martina, including 2 breaks of serve. So she's leading 3-1 and serving at the moment in the second set. Now out on number two court, young lady from Britain, Anne Hobbs, is playing against Mary Lou Piatek of the United States. And Miss Hobbs has won the first set 6-4. They're 1 game all in the second set. So young Anne, going well. Tremendous crowds out there, and that's the situation on number three court, where John Lloyd is playing in front of a huge crowd. Dropped the first set against Greg Holmes of the United States, but has won the opening game of the second set. There's John Lloyd. Great excitement on those outside courts. Now back to the center court.
Connors on a roll here. He's 3-love, second set.
Thank you. 15, love.
The astonishing zest and enthusiasm this man, 31, who's had a very long and hard career, a lot of it under strain, playing like a youngster, really.
First things, we've written him off several times over the years, and he's come back to show us that we were all wrong.
Love.
Now, the young Swede mustn't get frightened by the famous Connors running in like that. Connors was a bit off balance, actually, as he came forward, and the returner of the surf had a great chance there. Yes.
Forty-thirty.
Well, now, Simonson hasn't won more than 2 points in any game against the service. It's 40-30 at the moment.
Well, over on number one court, that little scare for Martina Navratilova seems to be over. She's broken back. She's trailing 2-3 in the second set against Amy Holton and serving.
And it's Simonson serving, love 4, second set, and he's lost 9 games in a row now.
Love 15.
Well done.
Fifteen all.
Very good anticipation and much better, firmer racket work there on the volley.
Forty-fifteen.
Very good half volley that. A little lucky in the end, but nice point, 40-15.
Game Simonson. Connors leads 4-1, second set, and by 1 set to love.
So there must be immense relief in the Swedish camp now that at last Simonsen here has his name on the scoreboard on the second set. And how nice to see this loyal support from fellow Swedes. In the centre of the picture there, Mats Wilander, the number 4 seed, and on his right as we look at them, Jan Gunnarsson of Sweden. He's ranked 50 in the world. One of 6 young Swedes in the top 50 in the world. That's an amazing thing in itself. And on the left, Jan Anders Sjögren, who now is the coach of Wilander. And last year looked after that travelling Swedish team of which Wilander was a part. And what a superb day again here, day 3 at Wimbledon. And the crowd seemingly are going to be breaking all records this year. And not just the royalty in the royal box, but our own Peter Ellis there, just about to have a look through the... And Brian Johnson, I see, from the worlds of golf and cricket. Among those in the Royal Box Party enjoying this match as we are. Connors, 4-1.
Dean Love. Pretty love. Forty love. Net. First service. Forty, game, Connors. Connors leads 5-1.
Serving them to a stay in the second set.
Love 15. Love 30. Love 40.
Three set points for 2 sets to love lead.
Game in second set, Connor. Second set, Connors 6-1. Connors leads by 2 sets to love.
John, when you see Connors playing like this, unless you're a very ardent and keen fan of tennis, you can't imagine that he was beaten 6-2, 6-2 at Queen's Club on grass by McEnroe in the semi-final, and 3 straight sets on clay. Can you? You really can't think that a man of this class can get beaten like that.
And who could ever believe that he lost 6-love, 6-love to Lendl, yes, on clay in the WCT Tournament of Champions in New York. There is really a gulf of class between a few players at the top of the world game, of which Connors is one, and everybody else. And I think we're seeing here today evidence of that. The wretched Simonsen simply doesn't have the equipment to deal with a player like Connors playing as well as this. Well as he's trying and fit as he is, trained as he is,
time,
he just does not have the shots. He hasn't got heavy enough ground shots to live with Connors off the ground. He hasn't got a big enough serve to follow it in and embarrass him there. And I don't think he's serving intelligently. He must serve at the body of Connors. He's serving them too wide and not hard enough, and is being
third set, Connors to serve,
being passed on the returns. But what a glorious sight Connors in full flight is. 6-2, 6-1, here's the third set.
Love 15.
Now, if he can keep making low, quick returns like that, he has a chance perhaps of breaking the set sometime. No, breaking the service sometime.
Love 15.
Well done. Interesting that Connors came in, didn't get the length, and his opponent being presented with a barely three-quarter length ball, very quick to snap it up. Yes, well done. Now that rather nice volley behind the very good approach shot gives him his first break point. Now let's see what the Swede does with it now. Pretty ruthless today, Mr. Connors.
Advantage, Connors.
The few errors that Connor's making are coming mostly off his forehand.
Simonson.
Break point then for the second time.
Simonson leads one game to love, third set. Connors leads by two sets to love.
And Simonson well rewarded for some hard work that he's put in this afternoon, and he's begun to change the tactics slightly, trying to do what Arthur Ashe did when he beat Jimmy Connors in the 1975 final here, taking the pace off the ball, letting Connors make it all. And sometimes he does make errors when he's doing that. But to take up the point Dan Maskell made just now, it is extraordinary to think that a man as good as this and playing generally, although he's just lost that last service game, playing generally today as well as he can play, it's amazing to think how he is embarrassed by particularly McEnroe on a fast surface and Lendl also on a fast surface. The reason is that he is denied time by both of them. What he is doing to Simonson here today is done to him by McEnroe, who takes the ball on the rise, particularly on the return of serve, and hit some very early passes and denies him any time to make those raking ground shots, and by Lendl, who does it with sheer brute force, those punishing forehands particularly. So in tennis, as in bridge, as in life, there are an infinite number of divisions of class. Simonsen, one love.
Fifteen, love. Thirty, love. Forty, love.
So,
Simonsen leads by 2 games to love.
So the first ace, and confirming the break of service by a love service game, increasing confidence certainly.
Love 15.
Well, that was a very close,
love 30.
Close ball, and Connors gives the baseline judge a look.
You saw the ball good? First of all, I'm not querying the ball. And second of all, if you saw it good and so did he, then you both should be dismissed. Thirty all.
Ironic that. Love 2, 40, 30.
Game coming. Simonsen leads by 2 games to 1, third set. Connors leads by 2 sets to love.
Well, it was the baseline decision that Connors thought was wrong. But if I heard correctly, and I wasn't sure what he said, if he said, you thought it was out, he thought it was out, if that's so, you should both be dismissed. If he did say that, then I think that is disgraceful, and I think that is something that the umpire should have taken up. I really do think it's time. We cannot have players saying things like that to court officials and still expect the public at large to have respect for the game. But in the end, it was the Connors tennis that had the last word. That first ace he served, game point. An indication of the great improvement since 2 years ago. He decided to throw the ball just a little bit further forward.
Time.
And it was that, I think, principally, which led him to his second title here. He'd first won in 1974. And in 1982, he beat McEnroe because he was serving so well and playing generally well. But Simonsen still has this break of serve. He's 2-1 in the third set.
Love 15. Love 15-all.
That's a great shot. Interesting thing happening here on this centre court now. Connors momentarily perhaps relaxed mentally and physically when he was two sets up. Took the grip off the Swede, and the Swede now is playing some of his best tennis. Just on the line that Bob lines him very quickly, put his hands down, palm of the hands to the ground, indicating to the umpire that it was good. And the server there having to withstand three of the most beautifully timed shots you'll ever see. Two ground strokes and the forehand volley. And everyone made the Connors racket sing.
advantage Connors.
And Connors has lifted his game when he was in peril here, 40-15, and now both playing at the same time and getting some really lovely shots and lovely tennis. Much more competitive now, in the sense that they're both, both playing so well. Great.
Advantage, Simonsen. Simonsen leads by 3-1.
And fortunate, he got away with a mishit ball that didn't bounce too well, as mishits often don't. And Connors wasn't quite quick enough to pick it up. So 1-3.
Love 15.
I think Connors must have thought he was playing Borg then, so much like the Borg disguised topspin lob. Oh,
one
surely.
Fault. One fault.
How can you see way over there and you can't see the ball right back there? Beyond my eye comprehension.
Well, now, the umpire has called for it. We didn't hear the linesman call, but the umpire has called it.
Love, 30. Love 40.
So a very interesting situation now, 1-3 and love 40.
Thirty forty.
Oh, a late call. Players really do dislike this. It was a fault, all right, but it was a late call.
Deuce. Advantage Simonsen.
And now Simonsen is really playing like a dream, leaning on his approach backhand. The slice shot there played perfectly.
First service. Advantage Connors.
Fine volley by Connors there. Deep and well placed, gave the Swede really no chance to control the lob. Oh, I say.
Deuce.
Well, we mentioned Borg a moment ago, but Borg couldn't have played a better one than that. That was a really magnificent pass. So it brings the score back to Deuce.
Advantage Connors.
What a good return.
Deuce.
Really has come alive now, Simonsen.
Advantage Connors.
Simonsen has asked the umpire whether he thought he agreed with that call. The umpire can't get the linesman to look at him, and he's not about to change it.
Simonsen leads by 3-2, third set. Connors leads by 2-0.
Now let me bring you some news that from number one court a few moments ago, Martina Navratilova, the number one seed and defending champion in the ladies' championship, put out Amy Holton, 19-year-old girl from Florida, 6-2, 7-5. The second set was really a stern battle for the champion. Now let me tell you what's been happening on court number two. Young Anne Hobbs of Great Britain has been playing Mary Lou Piatek of the United States there. One set up, 5-3 up, 30 all, Anne Hobbs serving. 2 points away from victory. This happened a few moments ago. So, match point to Anne Hobbs of Great Britain against Mary Lou Piatek of the United States. Return netted, and Anne Hobbs is through to the third round. So that's a fine win there for the young British girl. Now out on court number 12, another British girl playing, Julie Salmon against Beverly Mould of South Africa. And again, the British girl very close to winning and serving. Tie break in the second set that was, and Julie Salmon wins. I know the coverage is not to our usual standard, but that court's a long way away, and we're lucky to get a camera anywhere near to see the action. So there's another win for Britain. Julie Salmon beats Beverly Mould of South Africa, 6-4, 7-6. Now let's go back to the centre court.
So it's love 15 with Simonson serving and 3-2.
Love 30.
And I think Connors has really sensed that this young man in your picture has struck a patch of form, that when Connors left, had lost his grip on him at the beginning of this set, Connors has realised that he really mustn't take liberties and really moving like a dream again.
Oh. 15-30.
Break point.
Game Connors.
Beautiful lob.
Three games all.
So the first two sets to Connors, 6-2, 6-1, when it was all Connors, but certainly in this third set we're having a match.
Love. 30, love.
Well, he knows what it's like, that. He makes so many passes on the two-hander himself down the line. It really was a lovely Swedish stroke, that. Yes.
40-15.
Third ace from Connors. Well, I like the look of the Swede when he heard that ball called out and took no notice, produced that lovely cross-court pass anyway. 40-30.
Connors leads 4-3, third set, and by 2 sets to love.
Now let me just put you in touch with a match that's just started on number one court between Stefan Edberg of Sweden against the number 12 seed Johan Kriek. And Edberg has had a break of service there in the third game and leads 3-2 and serving. That match currently being seen on BBC Two.
And Jimmy Connors has certainly picked up the pace again. He had a slightly sloppy start to this set, disconcerted, I think, by some softer shots from his opponent, and he had to make all the pace. And he made some unforced errors, which previously in the match he hadn't done. And he really is an absolutely absorbing character to watch, Jimmy Connors. Tries 100% all the time.
Time.
And put such verve and energy into all he does. But there's never a dull moment. Well, Simonsen's lead is gone. Just a moment ago, he was 3-1. Now he's 3-4.
Love.
And that really is beautiful play.
30, love.
And there, the Swede really looked like an instinctive volleyer. That last backhand volley was quite gloriously played.
First service. Thirty-all. 30-40.
Oh, he needs a good service here. Break point.
Oh. Game coming.
So Connors back in the driving seat now. 5-3.
Connors leads.
And
five
what
games
a magnificent second point we had in that last game. 15-love he leads Simonsen, and he comes in. He has to decide which way to go. He reads it right, and that beautifully controlled volley, putting it totally out of Connor's reach. Well, now, the matter could all be over in 4 points. Connors is 6-2, 6-1, 5-3.
Love.
I rather think Mr. Connors would like to be able to serve throughout the championship as he did those first two serves of this game. So Connors has 3 match points.
Game set.
Lovely serve.
Wins by 3 sets to love, 6-2, 6-1, 6-3.
So Connors takes a run of 5 games from 1-3 in that third set when he looked as though he might have lost his grip on his opponent. Really, a really great performance by Connors.
Connors' next opponent will be Martin Davis of the United States. Now out on court number 13, there's an interesting match going on between Pam Shriver of the United States, the number 4 seed in the ladies' championship, and she's playing Gigi Fernandez of Puerto Rico. And